Good morning, everyone. I'll be talking about how native mammals are more resilient to fire in fox-baited landscapes. As most of you would know, in contrast to patterns of extinction on other continents where the main causes are habitat loss, hunting, or impacts of human development, the major drivers of faunal declines in Australia have been related to predation by foxes and feral cats and changes in fire regimes. Even the most native fauna have evolved with fire in Australia, inappropriate fire regimes since European colonization, particularly the fire frequency and intensity have long-term impacts on vegetation structure and complexity, which in turn affects the survival of a lot of the native animals. Foxes and cats have spread out pretty much across Australia and have caused severe reduction in critical bait range mammals, birds, and reptiles. There's been a lot of studies showing how foxes and cats have a larger impact around fire. So there's been studies showing how foxes and cats come from surrounding areas to a recently burned block and spend extended periods of time hunting on whatever is available. This is mostly because when a fire is happening, there's less vegetation and a lot of the native mammals survive on dense understory. The fox control through fox baiting is one of the most commonly used landscape scale methods for fox control across Australia. Even though it's been shown to reduce fox numbers, it's not shown to eradicate fox populations. With this in mind, the main aim of my PhD is to look at how or if native mammals respond better to fire in fox baited landscapes. This is important because even though fire and fox management are usually done on the same piece of land or the same region, they're often carried out as separate processes. By understanding this, I hope to bring together better strategies for threatened species conservation. So my main method of monitoring would be using camera trapping. I'll be doing this before and immediately after a fire, and I'll be doing this across baited and unbaited landscapes. So far, I've collected data from 8 burn blocks, which include baited and unbaited sites, and I'll be doing more surveys across my research. And the main method that I'm gonna use for analysis is multi-season single species modeling, which I'll be running through a package called Unmarked in R. So my study sites are in Southwest Victoria. I'm looking at two big regions, both of which have landscape scale fox control going on. So if you see the pictures here, the orange dots are where the bait stations are, and my burn blocks are pretty much spread across these regions. Apart from foxes and cats, I'll be looking at medium-sized native mammals that are present in the region, which include southern brown bandicoots, long-nosed potoroos, echidnas, and brush-tail and ring-tail possums. Just showing some preliminary results. When you look at foxes, after accounting for imperfect detection, you see that baiting doesn't have much effect on their initial occupancy. But after a fire, foxes seem to be more active across baited and unbaited sites, but the occupancies are slightly higher in unbaited blocks, which is the blue line. With feral cats, it is similar in the sense that there's not much effect on initial occupancy, but the occupancy after a fire is almost double across baited blocks. This could be partially related to a reduced presence of foxes in the baited blocks. With native mammals, baiting didn't have a strong effect on any of them. Especially with ring-tailed possums, baiting had no effect where ring-tailed possums went down across baited and unbaited blocks after a fire. Brush-tailed possums had some positive effect on baited blocks where their occupancies were slightly higher. With echidna, The sharp decline following a fire could be related to the fact that they go under hibernation during winter, which is when these control burns happen and which is when these surveys happen. With southern brown bandicoots and potoroos, they're not present in enough sites to have a strong understanding of the effects of baiting and fire. So their occupancies were quite low to start with, which is why they don't have a strong effect. So far the conclusion is that there is some effect of baiting on fox responses to fire, but it's not a very strong effect so far. With cats, you see that the increase is almost double following a fire in baited sites, and native mammal responses are a bit unclear as of now. With this in mind, I'm aiming to look at two other questions. I plan to look if the increase in cat activities after a fire is directly related to the presence or absence of foxes. And the other thing that I aim to look at is how important understory vegetation is in native mammal responses to fire. So things like distance to the nearest burnt or unburnt patch and how severe the control burn was, and height vegetation in different height categories like 10 centimeters, 20 centimeters, 50 centimeters, how important these factors are in native mammal responses to fire. Huge thanks to all my supervisors and forest fire management team and all the volunteers that have been helping me so far. Thank you.